Oh my god. Covering my hair up because it looks ridiculous. La, 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 la. Hey guys, how are you? It's Lindy and welcome to a new video. Today's video is a very exciting video for two reasons. First reason is it is a sponsored video. So today's video is kindly sponsored by VP Fashion, and of course this will not change my opinion in any way. I will always be 100% honest with you guys. And the second reason why this is a very exciting video is because I got a wig! So VP Fashion sent me over a human hair wig. Oh my god, for me to try out. So in today's video I'm going to show you guys this wig. I'm going to try it out for myself and I'm going to dye it. I actually haven't seen it yet. I just received it in the mail like an hour ago. So we're gonna unbox it together. So if you're interested in that, then please keep on watching. Someone actually told me that my plant isn't dead. It's supposed to be like this, but honestly, it looks very sad to me, but luckily it's still alive, so good job. So this is the current state of my hair and I don't like it. If I'm gonna be totally honest with you guys, I really don't like it. So I'm just gonna put this thing back on my head. So I've been trying out to wear some wigs, but the only wigs that I own are synthetic wigs. And I just, for the life of me, can't make those look natural. Like, it's really difficult. So, VP Fashion actually sent me over a human hair wig. And it's customized to my own head, so it should fit perfectly. So let me just like open it, and then we can see what's inside the box. So, this is what it looks. This is what it looks like from the inside. It comes with two wig caps and, of course, the wig. Oh my god. So the hairstyle is called W613A and the hair color is 613A as well. And that is like this color. So this is the color that's like meant for dyeing. And the hair texture is silky straight. And I'm pretty sure that the length is 12 inches. Oh my god, I'm so excited for this. Oh, already feels so soft and it's still in the packaging. So this is the wig, my new girlfriend. It feels really soft. And of course, this color is not the color that you're gonna keep it unless you want it to be this color. But like I said, this is like a dyeable wig. So I am actually going to dye it. Well, tone it. So this is the inside of the wig and it has the clips in there as well to secure it. And this wig actually is like full lace, so all the hairs are like sewn in there individually, so that means that you can part it everywhere you want to. So happy about it. So I'm just gonna like quickly like put it on my head and see what it looks like. Wig cap is on. Let's put the wig on my head. Oh my god. Who is she? Like I said, it is custom made, so it actually fits perfectly on my head. And that is one of the problems that I always have with those synthetic wigs, is that they're just way too big for me. I don't know, but I always thought that I had a big head, but apparently I have a pretty small head. It feels so good to be able to like put my hands through my hair again. Oh my god. So I'm just going to tone this wig right now because of course it's looking pretty damn yellow and that's not what we're going for. So to tone the wig, I'm going to use the Fanola No Yellow Shampoo. And I actually bought this because a lot of you recommended it to me and it works so good. So I hope that it's going to turn this wig into some beautiful like platinum hair, because that's the color that I want. So let's start dyeing her. Hello and welcome at my dining table. This is where the magic is gonna happen. Also, I don't know why I'm still wearing this wig cap. Let me just... Oh yeah, now I remember why I wore a wig cap. Yeah, this is probably better. So, what I'm going to do to tone my wig is I'm going to use this method that I found online where you fill a top with water, with like warm or hot water, and then you put the hair dye, and in this case the shampoo, in the tub, and then you take your wig and you just like dip it in the water, and apparently that's going to make the wig like evenly dyed, because I've noticed with a lot of like hair extensions that I used to have, if I try to dye it, it always came out very uneven. So I'm going to try this method. So I'm just going to fill this top with hot water, and then I'm going to dip my beautiful wig. Rude! And then I'm going to dip my beautiful wig in there. So my tub is filled with hot water. Of course, make sure that you don't burn your hands. My hands are pretty heat resistant, so I can take a lot of heat. But you know, make sure that you don't burn them, because we don't want that. So I'm taking my Fanola No Yellow Shampoo, and I'm just going to put that in here. Pablo, be careful, that's too hot for you, boy. I really hope this is gonna work. Like, swirl it all around. And then I'm going to take my beautiful wig. And I hope to God that's gonna work. So let me just dip her in there. Whoa, it works immediately, holy sh! Okay. Oh my God, look at this. Whoa, what the f? Okay, so let me just dip her in there entirely. Soak her in there. Oh my God, look at the difference. I'm actually so surprised that this works so good. So yeah, those few dips actually changed the entire wig. So I'm just going to wash it out with cold water real fast, and then I'll be right back. Okay, so here I am again with my beautiful wig. It is totally dried, and as you can see, it really worked. It's so much more toned right now. It doesn't look yellow anymore. It's now more of like a silvery platinum color. It is kind of patchy on some places, but honestly nothing too bad. So also, Pablo is hiding behind the wig. Hey boy. But what I'm now going to do is I'm just going to style the wig, because as you can see, it is looking kind of fluffy right now. So I'm just going to take my flat iron, this one, and I'm just going to flat iron it. And before I do that, I'm going to put some like heat protecting spray in it, because we don't want to damage the hair. So I'm gonna just do that right now. So she is all straightened up, as you can see. So now I'm just going to get a little bit of oil, and I'm just going to rub that in her hair, so it gets a little bit of sheen. So the last thing I'm going to do to make her look even more beautiful than she already does is I'm going to pluck the hairline, because the hairline hasn't been plucked yet. So what that does is that it kind of creates like a straight line over here. Like, the hairline is just like a straight line. And if you would look at your own hairline, it wouldn't be like straight. The hairs at the front are a little bit thinner than if you go further back. So I'm just going to get my tweezers, and I'm going to pluck some hairs at the front. So onto the very last step of making this hair my beautiful hair. And that is cutting the lace at the front, because over here you've got like some lace that needs to be cut off, because of course that doesn't look very natural if you walk around with like a flap of lace on your forehead. But before I do that, I just want to show you guys something that I just found out about, and that is at like the inner part of the wig, at the back, whoop, you actually have adjustable straps, which comes in so handy because you can actually make the wig tighter to fit your hair. So I made it a little bit tighter on both ends, just so it will be like stuck on my head a little bit better. So now I'm just going to pop it on my head. Take my head off. Oh my God, this is so bad. So, who is she? And of course using the clips at the side as well. Oh my god, this looks so pretty! Oh my god. So the last thing that I would do, but I'm not going to do that today, is actually like glue the wig down on like the edge of it by just using some like Got to Be gel or something, because that way you make sure that it's like really flat on your head and that it's gonna stay there the entire day. But like I said, I'm not going to do that today because I'm not gonna keep it on for the entire day, so it will be kind of a waste. So then I'm just going to do one more thing, and I promise this is the last thing I'm going to do. And that is, I'm just going to put a little bit of like concealer or foundation on the parting, so it kind of blends in with my skin color, because you can kind of see the wig cap underneath it. So I'm just going to use my Fenty Beauty foundation, the one I'm wearing right now. Oh, this looks so beautiful. I'm so happy that I have hair again. Oh, this looks so much like the hair that I used to have like a year ago. I'm so happy that I have hair again. The whole end of the video is just going to be me like running my hands through my hair, because I can finally do it again. I'm so happy. So yeah guys, this is the end result of me trying a human hair wig for the very first time in my life, and honestly I am so impressed. This looks way better than all these synthetic wigs I've tried before. Honestly, I feel like if I would go out with this wig, honestly nobody would know that I'm wearing a wig, because it just looks that natural. It's so beautiful, I honestly could cry. So yeah, my end review of this wig is that it is super gorgeous. I love it so much. It still feels really soft. It did feel softer in the box when I got it, but I'm pretty sure that they put like this protective layer on top of the hair to make it feel softer. So if you're gonna like wash it and stuff, you are gonna wash like the softness away. But it is still pretty soft, so like the dyeing and the washing didn't totally ruin the wig. Not at all. It's still pretty soft and shiny and gorgeous. And I just want to wear this wig forever and not have to look at myself with short hair again. So I really hope you guys liked this video. A lot of you actually requested this. So here it is. A video about a wig. So if you like this video, please don't forget to give it a thumbs up. Also, please don't forget to follow me on my Instagram. And of course, a big special thank you to VP Fashion for sponsoring the video and also giving me this beautiful, luscious wig. I will leave all the details of the wig and of their website and everything in the description box down below. So, yeah, thank you guys for watching, and I really hope to see you in my next video. Bye bye.